माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10th, वेलकम टू टुडे क्लास ऑफ द ब्लड वैस्कुलर सिस्टम। एंड इन दिस ब्लड वैस्कुलर सिस्टम द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज दैट इज ब्लड प्रेशर। सो इन दिस वीडियो यू विल वॉच द थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू द ब्लड प्रेशर। एंड ब्लड प्रेशर इज द प्रेशर बाय विच द ब्लड कैन फ्लो इन साइड द ब्लड वैस्कुलर सिस्टम लाइक वेन्स एंड आर्टरीज। सो द प्रेशर दैट इज क्रिएटेड बाय द पंपिंग स्टेशन दैट इज हार्ट ऑन द फ्लूइड सो दैट दैट फ्लूइड कैन एक्सर्ट द प्रेशर ऑन द वॉल्स ऑफ द ब्लड वेसल्स लाइक वेन्स एंड आर्टरीज। So that blood pressure is very important because this pressure maintain the flow of the blood inside the arteries and veins. As you know that arteries carries oxygenated blood from the heart to different parts of the body and veins carries deoxygenated blood or blood that is mixed with the carbon dioxide from the different parts of the body coming to the heart. The exception is that the pulmonary arteries supply deoxygenated blood from heart to the lung and the pulmonary vein supply oxygenated blood from lung to the heart. So that heart can pump this oxygenated blood via its aorta to the different parts of the body. My dear students, this heart is having the blood pressure can be measured. This, my dear students, in the heart, from the heart and to the veins, the blood pressure can be measured as systole and diastole. Systole is having the highest pressure, that is the pressure exerted by the heart, and that pressure experienced by the walls of the veins and arteries, as well as the diastole is the pressure that is exerted on the veins and the blood by that pressure blood is coming inside the heart. So systole, that is the ongoing blood from the heart to the different parts of the body. Diastole, that is the pressure by which the blood is coming inside the heart from the different parts of the body. In this simple way, you can understand this. Along with this, my dear students, you have to understand that, as you know, the heart produces sound when it get contracted and relaxed. So my dear students, you have already learned about the blood flow inside the heart by the heart valve, heart valves like tricuspid valves, pulmonary valves, then two other valves that are situated in the left part of the that are situated in the left part of the heart, in between the left atrium and left ventricle. So that is mitral valve and aortic valve. So these are the valves that you have already seen, and these valves produces sound like lub and dub, lub dub sound that has been produced by these valves, and these sound ensure the systole and diastole. So systole is the, in other words, you can understand like systole is the pressure that is exerted by the heart on the arteries, and diastole that is pressure exerted by the heart on the veins. In this way, you can understand this thing. So, my dear students, systole will be always 120 to 130. This is the normal range, that is ranging 120 to 130. While diastole, that is ranging from 80 to 90 or 85. You can write like this. 80 to 85, these are the normal range. In other words, you can say that 120/80 mmHg, this is the most suitable normal blood pressure. And when it increases, then there will be the problem of hypertension that is felt by the concerned person, by the patient. And the factors by which this pressure of blood is to be increased are the deposition of the cholesterol inside the blood vessels. The deposition of the cholesterol, like if suppose this is the blood vessel, then the cholesterol, that is bad cholesterol, that is coming inside this blood vessel, and that get deposited inside the wall of the blood vessel, which narrows the passage of the blood flow. If the cholesterol is depositing over here, then you see there will be the narrower space for the blood flow inside the vessels. So automatically, if the space will be narrow, then the pressure will be high. The pressure exerted by the blood on its wall, that will be high. So this is the main factor for the high blood pressure. Similarly, if this happen in this arteries and veins, like these are the coronary artery, coronary veins, these are the coronary blood vessels, and these coronary blood vessels supply the blood to the heart for its function. So if the coronary inside the coronary artery deposition of the cholesterol will be there, then there may be the blockage, because these coronary artery and veins are very thin, that is having very narrow space, and if any cholesterol molecule get deposited inside it, then there may be the blockage of the flow of the blood inside this coronary vessels, and this is called coronary heart disease. So in this disease, the heart can stop its function because of the non-supply of the blood due to the blockage in this coronary vessels. Therefore, my dear students, the main factor, that is the cholesterol, what you have already studied in the chapter of nutrition, cholesterol, that is the fat. Cholesterol is the simpler molecule of the fat, but this cholesterol is of two types, HDL and VLDL. My dear students, this HDL is very important, high density lipid, and that is very important and very essential for the proper function of this heart and vessels. So if heart required any kind of cholesterol, then that will be the HDL. But VLDL, this is the bad cholesterol, and this bad cholesterol is the factor for the creation of the disease of the hypertension and coronary heart disease. So my dear students, in the blood pressure, you have to have the knowledge of these things that is related with the factors. माय डियर स्टूडेंट, सेकेंड फैक्टर इज द सोडियम आयन. सोडियम आयन इंक्रीजेस द सोडियम आयन इंक्रीजेस द प्रेशर ऑफ ब्लड एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ दैट आयन दैट इट इंक्रीजेस द प्रेशर ऑफ ब्लड इनसाइड द ब्लड वेसल्स. सो सोडियम आयन मे कॉज द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ हाइपरटेंशन. हाई सोडियम इनटेक, हाई सोडियम साल्ट इनटेक दैट कॉज द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ हाइपरटेंशन. सो इफ द पेशेंट इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम द हाई ब्लड प्रेशर द दैट विल बी एडवाइज बाय द डॉक्टर टू स्टॉप द टेकिंग सोडियम साल्ट एंड फैटी फूड्स, स्पेशली बैड फैट्स. बट इफ द ब्लड प्रेशर इज लो, दैट इज लो, देन देर विल बी द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ reaching of the blood to all parts of the body, then that has to be maintained by giving the sodium salt to that particular patient. Or cholesterol rich food. Okay, so if anything is coming in front of you related to the systole and diastole, you have to explain the things like this. Systole that is 120 to 130. Earlier it was 120. Nowadays, due to the changed lifestyle, it is considered up to the 130. And diastole that is ranging from the 80 to 85. So systole is the highest blood pressure and diastole that is the lowest blood pressure. The pressure by which the blood is coming inside the heart, that is diastole, and the pressure by which the blood is going out to all parts of the body, that is called systole. And these systole and diastole can be understood by the loud sound produced by the heart. So, my dear student, these are the mechanism of the blood flow inside the blood vascular system, as well as the diseases related to the blood vascular system, functioning of the heart, blood flow, double circulation, oxygenated, deoxygenated blood, and the maintenance of the rhythmic contraction relaxation of the heart muscles. My dear student, as you know, once is switched on during the start of the life of a human, either inside the mother body or outside the mother body, then the heart get automatically switched on and it function throughout the life. So the especially these cardiac muscles that constitute the heart, they are having the property to, once it switched on, it act, it function throughout the life of the human, and the human get proper nourishment, proper nutrition, all the essential substances that are transported by this blood vascular system through the blood to all parts of the body, which absorbed from the small intestine, as well as the gases is absorbed from the lungs, that is carrying out by this blood vascular system. So my dear students, you have to learn it very carefully, and you have to have the knowledge of the structure of this blood vascular system in human, that is blood vessels, heart, the physiology of the blood flow inside the heart, from heart to the lungs, and from lungs to the heart, and from heart to the different parts of the body. Thank you very much for watching this video, and you have to learn this blood pressure. Thank you.